We had friends over this past weekend and our kids were off playing with their kids and it was a really lovely time. They know the work that I do and the work that I have done working in sex ed, being a sex ed educator and teacher, teaching human sexuality. And they were very familiar with how I talk with my kids and how I'm very open with them when it comes to sex and sexuality. The mom pulls me aside and asks me this question. She goes, "Well, when do you know that your kids are really ready for the sex talk?" And I was like, "That's a great question. I'm really happy that you came to me with that question. You know, what do you think? What do you consider to be the ideal age for having the sex talk?" Does that sound a little bit familiar? If it doesn't sound familiar, check out this video on answering sex questions. Anyways, this is It's Time for the Sex Talk for Parents. I'm Kathleen Hema. Thank you for joining me. I have 5 questions that I'm gonna pose to you to see how you answer them and you can gauge whether or not your child is ready for the sex talk. Let's take a look. Let's break it down. Let's answer these 5 questions. Do you know what the perfect age is to have the sex talk with your child? Do you have an age? Is the age 16, 12, 8? Have you picked an age yet? Let me give you some stats, okay? Before we decide on the perfect number or perfect age to have the sex talk with your child, here are some statistics. According to the Youth Risk Behavior Survey conducted in the United States in 2017, almost 40% of 15 to 19 year olds engaged in sexual activity or had sex at least once. 28% of 15 to 19 year olds had engaged in sex leading up to taking that survey. By the time they took that survey, the question was posed, "Have you engaged in sexual intercourse in the past 3 months?" And 28% of 15 to 19 year olds had said yes. Now, according to RAIN, the Rape, Abuse, Incest National Network, 34% of children under the age of 12 have been sexually assaulted or sexually abused. So they've been victims of sexual abuse or sexual assault. 34% under the age of 12. And lastly, according to the Guttmacher Institute, even with all the significant declines in the teen pregnancy and teen birth rates in the United States, the United States still remains one of the highest rates of teen births in the industrialized world. From these stats, what is the ideal age to have the sex talk with your child? You know, I don't think there is an ideal age. I think it's talking early and talking often. Talking about good touch, bad touch, appropriate touch with your elementary and intermediate age child. Talking about what a condom is with your middle and high school age child. Talk about the sexual and reproductive body parts with your elementary and intermediate age child. So that when your child is in the middle and high school age groups, that the conversation isn't about what the body parts are and how they work. It's more of, you know what the body parts are. Let's talk about consent. Let's talk about enthusiastic consent. Let's talk about how to say no to behavior that you don't want to engage in. You can move the conversation into those kinds of topics later on if you've gotten all the medically accurate stuff out of the way early. Next question in answering, is your child really ready for the sex talk? Does your child have access to the internet? Now, I mean this for real. I have a 4.5-year-old. She has access to my phone and tablet. Most of the time, I'm right there with her. But sometimes I do let her just watch a show. She has the dexterity to swipe. She can get to the next episode or put on the next song. She's very savvy with the phone. Does that mean she's gonna start searching sex questions in a web browser? Well, not yet. She can't quite read or type. But what it does let me know is that I have a limited time window to lay a foundation of letting her know, hey, when you have a question, you can come to me and I can give you an answer. Because if she doesn't feel comfortable coming to me for an answer, she might go to the internet. And is the internet gonna provide her with the most age-appropriate and medically accurate answers to her questions? Probably not the way that I would provide it to her. You might be saying out there, but Kathleen, of course there are other things that you can restrict her use of internet and things like that. You can pay for subscriptions and you can make sure that she doesn't or she is not able to access certain things on the internet. That is totally true. But my partner and I, we have chosen to go a different route. We really don't want to restrict her use or censor her use. In that regards, we really want to help her learn and teach her how to use the internet appropriately, advise her and let her know that there are gonna be things as she gets older that once you see something on the internet, you can't unsee it, and not just related to sex. We wanna teach her how to use the internet, not restrict her use of the internet. Because if we restrict her use of the internet at home, she's just gonna go to the library and search something, or she's going to do it at school, or she's going to go to a friend's house. And that brings me to the next question, in how do you know your child is really ready for the sex talk? Does your kid talk to other kids? Most likely yes, right? Your kid has friends, they talk to other kids. Now, there aren't too many topics in school that you will receive as a parent a opt-in or opt-out letter letting you know what your child will be learning, and you have the choice to opt them into the program or opt them out of the program. However, sex education is one of them. What I have noticed when I was teaching sex ed in the classroom was after the teacher took attendance, the children who were opted out and not allowed to participate in the sex ed lesson that I was going to be providing, the teacher would say, call out their names, they would have to go to the library and do something else during that class time. It is completely fine. I do believe it is up to the parents, and they can get to make that choice when their child is ready to hear this information. However, does your kid talk to other kids? The children that were not in the classroom, if they are talking to children that were in the classroom, if you've ever played the game of telephone, you kind of know what happens. As information gets passed on from one student to another student to another student, misinformation will occur. One time I was in a class and I had lunch and I was taking my lunch break outside, and a group of students were joking around and talking, and one of the students came over that had left the class, so they didn't stay in for the sex ed class. One of the kids said to them, hey, how come you're not in the class? Why did you have to leave? And the other student replied saying, oh, you know, I don't know, my parents, they just said I wasn't ready, or they don't think I'm ready to hear this information just yet. What did the teacher talk about, or what did she say? I remember this clearly. The student said, and this is in his words, if you keep jerking off so much, your dick's gonna fall off. And they all proceeded to laugh. Maybe he knew that that student knew he was joking and his penis would not actually fall off. I don't know what that other student knew. I don't know if he knew what jerking off was, or if he knew what masturbation is, or if he was doing it excessively and this might have put something in his head that, oh my God, I'm, you know, something is wrong with me, or something bad will happen to me. So I actually interrupted and I said, excuse me, I don't think you were listening in my class, because that is not exactly what I said. Nobody's penis will fall off or come off due to excessive masturbation. They all kind of like quickly like got up and they were like, oh, okay, sorry, ma'am. And they all walked away. And the student wasn't in the class and he didn't get to hear the information that I provided. And I don't know if his parents are gonna cover that information. Parents, if you are choosing to opt out your child of a sex ed lesson, opt yourself in. Find out what's gonna be covered in that class and find out from the sex ed teacher, or ask them, you know, can I observe the class, or can I find out what you are teaching, what materials you are using? And many times, right, they are willing to share this information with you. They're willing to have you come in and even observe. But if you're gonna opt your child out, opt yourself in and find out what it is, or what specifically is the issue that you are uncomfortable with having your child hear. Figure out what it is, and then that way you can address it and move forward so that your children can get the correct information from the teacher and the educator instead of hearing misinformation from their friends. Next question. Do you know what your child already knows? Personal story time here. I'm going to tell about the time when I first learned what sex was, or the word sex. I was in third grade. A friend came up to me and said, Kathleen, do you do your homework on the bus? And I said, yeah. And they said, so you do it on the bus? I was like, yeah, I do it on the bus, so then I don't have to do it at home. And they all started to laugh, like him and all the other ones that were around. And I was like, what's so funny? They were like, you do it on the bus. And I was like, yeah, I do it on the bus. What are you talking about? I'm doing my homework. And he's like, do it. And I was like, yeah, I don't get it. And I remember feeling like, I don't understand, something is funny, but nothing that I'm saying sounds funny at all. Later on, he finally came up to me and said, when you say do it means sex. And I was like, oh, okay. I didn't know what sex was. I was just like, oh, okay, because apparently everybody else knew. The problem is I never told my parents. I don't know why. I just didn't feel comfortable, or I didn't know, maybe this was something wrong or naughty or bad, or everybody was already making fun of me and everybody already knew. There was this mystery around the word of sex. In the end, I never actually told my parents. I don't actually remember figuring it out or being told. I do remember in fifth grade when we actually had sex ed, our first formal sex ed class, that my mom did tell me what sex was, but I had heard this word 2 years earlier. So when it comes to how do you know your child is really ready for the sex talk, find out what they already know, because you may think they don't know something and they already do. Okay, so last question. This is the last question to help you figure out if your child is ready for the sex talk, and it is, do you want your child to be in a healthy sexual relationship in the future? In the end, I'm not oblivious. I know that eventually they will probably have sex. Talking about sex is not going to make your child engage in sex any sooner than if you were not talking about sex. Talking about sex is actually going to help your child to make informed choices that help to prevent those negative consequences from happening. They will then know what a condom is and what birth control is and how to prevent some of the things that comes along with sex, STIs or pregnancy, and that they can protect themselves. Those are the five questions. Did you answer yes to any of those five questions? Did you say, yes, my kid talks to other kids? Or yes, my child uses the internet? Or yes, I want them to have a healthy sexual relationship in the future? If you answered yes to any of those questions, the real question here is not, is your child ready for the sex talk? The question is, are you ready for the sex talk? So if you do not feel ready right now to answer a sex question or to talk about sexuality with your child right now, or if they were to come up to you and say, how are babies made, and you stumble and you're not sure how to answer that, join me. Subscribe right now. I will continue to bring you a video every week to help you build your confidence in talking about sex and sexuality with your child. I want you to be your child's primary sexual health educator. So join me. This is It's Time for the Sex Talk for Parents, and I'm Kathleen Hema. Thanks for watching.